Suncoast View for hot topics, everyday issues, celebrities, food, fashion, fitness, and everything in between. Nothing is off limits.
They're just fun.
For smart, fun talk in the morning, watch Suncoast View live at 9, weekdays on ABC 7.
They are the greatest fighting force the world has ever seen. But what does it take to bridge the distance and keep them connected to family, home, and country? What does it take to strengthen our service members so they can be the greatest force for good in the world? It takes a force. Be a force behind the forces. Give today at force.uso.org.
The body, it is a work of art and a powerful ally in the fight against cancer. A new approach called immunotherapy works by helping our immune system correctly identify and eradicate many types of cancer cells. Speak with your doctor and visit su2c.org/immunotherapy to learn more. Your body might just be your greatest hope.
Are you a food lover, restaurant goer, or home cook? Then check out My Suncoast Dining on MySuncoast.com, your guide to the foodie lifestyle. ABC 7's own Chef Judy serves up her favorite recipes, cooking tips and trends, dining blogs, and helpful step-by-step videos. And you'll love the restaurant guide with direct links to your favorite Suncoast eateries. Whether you're cooking in or dining out, whet your appetite with tasty tips from Chef Judy at MySuncoast.com/dining. It's rainy season on the Suncoast. Storms can pop up at a moment's notice. Sometimes it's just rain. Sometimes it's much worse. When severe weather strikes, trust ABC 7 First Alert Weather. We're here for you.
Through Saturday, RAV4s from 29. VeniceToyota.com.
Today on Suncoast View, red tide rescheduling. Huge area festivals are forced to postpone because they can't taste the risk that red tide will keep everyone home. We'll discuss.
There is some amazing public art in Sarasota, and the Arts Alliance wants to make sure you look up from your phone and see it. We'll tell you all about their scavenger hunt.
And the Oslo Rep is kicking off their 60th season here on the Suncoast, and they're bringing in some big Broadway names to do it. We'll preview The Music Man. All that and more right now on Suncoast View.
Welcome to the show. Happy Friday, everybody.
It is happy.
Always glad
Yay.
To make it to Friday. And welcome to Oslo Rep, producing artistic director, Michael Donald Edwards.
Great to be here, guys. Yes. Great to be here.
Great to see you.
Yes.
Now, I know you are very bothered by the Band-Aid,
yes,
so we're
indeed.
Just going to address it right off the bat. And I
yes.
think it's an important story.
I just had a carcinoma removed from my ear with the, what they call the Mohs surgery.
Sure.
Which is a lengthy, like, 6-hour process where they take as little as possible of the spot, the top of my ear it was. And we got to the end of it and got it all, and there was a big hole in my ear, and I thought, my ladies are not going to like that. So we did a skin graft as well.
Okay.
And the stitches come out on Tuesday. So I feel this is a very Sarasota look.
Yes,
really.
It is.
It's a very Florida
really
look. It is. It's one of our
look.
Big risks. Now,
and
I
was spotted, sorry, yeah?
I want you to tell the most important part of the story is you found this.
Well, it was my hairdresser, Jim Lewis. He was like cutting my hair. A month ago, he said, you know, you've got something, you need to get this looked at mm-hmm. now. I suggest you do that now. So I went in, Dr. Elizabeth Callahan, it's her office, Skin Smart, and Dr. Adams did the surgery. And she said, well spotted. That is that is really good. Did a biopsy immediately and found that it had to come out. I mean, I've had them done before, usually spotted by her in the annual check. But it was a sign, you know, you probably need to be more alert than just the mm-hmm. annual check. Don't mm-hmm. rely on that.
Well, and big kudos to hairdressers because they see parts of us that I don't know what my scalp looks like.
Exactly.
But
right.
my hairdresser does. Yeah. So, and I know that they have been encouraged by dermatologists
and it's like,
to look and talk.
Yeah. And my whole family has it. My dad lost his whole ear. He was in the military and they didn't know anything in those days. And it can be very aggressive. It can have a root system that go, you know a little bit
about
that.
Yeah, I had it done by Dr. Callahan a year ago.
Yeah.
And I don't think you can tell now.
No, not at all.
But it could have saved my life
in
the long run.
Big props to both of you, because Linda had it done and still came on air with a bandage on her nose, and you had it done and you have a bandage on your ear.
Well,
it's
so
much more important.
This has been especially created to impress you.
Yes.
I mean, I stopped short of a rainbow flag. I thought that would be doing too much. But
it's very Van Gogh of you, I have to say.
White goes with the shirt.
Oh, yes, of
course. Very nice. Okay. And Linda picked the Band-Aid shade that was closest to her skin so we could camouflage with makeup, remember?
Oh, that didn't exactly work, but I felt good.
But it encourages you to go, don't put off a checkup because you don't want to walk around with a Band-Aid for a week.
Tops of the ears and noses, the most vulnerable, and backs of the hands.
Yes, I have heard all of that as well, especially with men, the ears.
Yeah, the ears.
Because yours aren't covered like ours are with hair. So, well, we're proud of you.
Thank you, Nan. Great to be here.
Thankful that both of you have
been smart. Thank you for talking about me. It's my favorite thing.
That's why we're here.
So well-versed on the subject.
All right, well, something else we're going to talk about, because this alarmed Joey, the storms last night.
Yes. All right, so we have in our house those Philips Hue lights where you can control them from your phone. All of a sudden at 12:30, we hear the sound of thunder, and then all of the lights go on because we lost power, and when it came back, all of our lights went on. So it woke me up, and I thought, oh, is it time to go to work? It's time to go to work. And luckily, it was only 12:30. But I've talked to a bunch of my friends who have said, like, they've woken up and their pool was filled with mulch. I mean, it was a big
storm. Oh, they've
been
whipping through at night.
It was thrilling.
Did you hear it?
We opened all the blinds.
I thought somebody was banging on the side of my house.
Yeah.
But I didn't want to go look.
Oh, I'm like with Michael. I opened the blinds.
We opened all the blinds, and there were sheets of lightning. It was dramatic. I mean, I guess Florida, we have the most spectacular storms.
We do have great lightning.
And I thought, you know what? I'm going to put that on stage. People say I go too far with the storm effects. No. That was fantastic.
Oh, it is. And to lay in bed and witness it, it's my favorite thing ever.
Sexy.
I was just worried about the dog because I thought, oh my gosh, because she sleeps out in her own special place. And I was like, should I go get her?
Wait a minute.
She has her own room. It's beautiful.
Really?
Oh, yeah. It's nicer than most of the places I ever lived in New York. But. So she was fine, but I was more concerned.
She said, what storm?
Exactly. And it could explain why we're a little groggy today, too, because I think there were a few middle of the night wake ups. Mm-hmm. It's been a couple nights of that, but that's all right. We'll be happy it's Friday. All right, we're also happy when we have a friend in our Rice's Appliance Kitchen today. Bob from Gold Roast Barbecue back with us. What are we making in a very harvest looking scene you have?
Exactly. Well, fall is here, and we are going to spike up the holiday with some
sweet
cinnamon whiskey, fireball pumpkin pie.
Linda, have you run into fireball yet? It is a very popular, it's trending, I would say.
Mm-hmm.
It is trending.
No, that's probably why I haven't run into
it.
I think you'll like it, and that is the problem.
That is the problem. It tastes kind of like a cinnamon red hot, and one does not remember that it is whiskey.
Yes.
Oh, really? This sounds interesting.
Right, yes. And someone might give you a little and say, well, just have a little. It tastes lovely. And then you do. And then you have more, because it tastes lovely.
Maybe I shouldn't do this alone.
Well, I think we're putting it in a pie, so it'll be a
little
more.
In a pie!
It'll be okay.
Oh, in a pie.
Yeah, that really would make Thanksgiving more entertaining. I'm thinking I'll need this recipe. All right, well, Joey has a great story to share, and it may be something that you saw on our show yesterday. We had some Fred Astaire dancers with us.
Wonderful. Tim Panenga and Tiana Ramirez from Fred Astaire Dance Company, and they have a big showcase this weekend. So they gave us a performance, and I, the entire time, was looking at Tiana going, is she pregnant? And I couldn't get it out of my mind. And the way she's moving, you can see, I was like, she's not moving like a pregnant person I've ever seen. So I didn't say anything. None of us did. I did not ask her during the interview.
Yes.
And afterward, we found out she's 8.5 months pregnant.
And you couldn't really be sure.
No.
I did not want to say a word because I thought, well, you know, maybe she's just built that way.
Right.
Exactly.
And one of our viewers actually stopped me yesterday afternoon and said, that dancer, was she pregnant? And I said, I couldn't ask because I was raised to never ask someone.
And that's very, very correct. Never ask unless you see the baby.
Yes.
Literally falling out.
And I still won't ask at that point. So 8.5 months pregnant, and she surely was, and she was very gracious and volunteered the information after the interview. So what our viewers didn't get to see. Well, yes, she threw down a microphone and posed.
Yeah, but the way she moved, I mean, holy cow, at 8.5 months, I could barely walk up the stairs.
Yes. So everyone had the same question that I did.
Right.
that Linda did, and the answer is yes, and isn't that even more impressive?
Yes. But it is impressive, but you handled it very correctly, because that is just one of those things.
I was dying to
if
ask.
She had said no, and
right,
she hadn't
then
been,
there's nothing to do but crawl under the table.
Yes. One time I saw people dining out, and I made the mistake of going, oh, are these your parents? And it was their cousins, and I was so embarrassed,
right.
So now I just don't ask anything. I
correct.
Assume everyone is young and not pregnant.
That's a good philosophy.
That's like living in my house with teenagers. That's, I assume, the same today. All right, well, if you want to see the dancers, Fred Astaire is presenting Legends of Yesteryear at the Van Wezel Performing Arts Hall. That is coming up Saturday, tomorrow, 7 p.m. And for more information, you can go to fredastaire.com/Sarasota. Today is also Makeover Madness. We have a great makeover on the way. Her name is Sarah Wood, and she works in food services for Sarasota County Schools. Her friend actually nominated her because she said she deserved something for herself. Our friends at Cutting Loose Salons are working with her now. We'll, of course, see the end result toward the end of the show. A lot of fun for a Friday.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah.
It is time for our first hot topic, and sadly, it is not so fun. Red tide continues to affect our beaches and coastline. We are now seeing cancellations of events months into the future. The International Chalk Festival in Venice has canceled in November. They are hoping to reschedule. The nonprofit cultural arts organization in charge says it is too much of a financial risk for their small group to hold this event, meaning if people don't come, they can't recoup the costs. Really bad news for anglers as well. Florida Fish and Wildlife have extended restrictions on snook and redfish through 2019 to catch and release only. That is simply to protect the fish stock, as obviously thousands are dying. Sadly, FWC also reports that there are no signs currently that red tide is easing up.
Oh.
It really bummed me out to see an event as so far as November being canceled. And I know it's the what if. We just apparently don't know enough to know when it eases up, and they can't take the risk.
And they're booking these artists from all over the world.
Exactly.
So they're bringing them in by flights from all over, hotel rooms and everything. So it's a big expense for them.
Now, on a positive note, Clearwater is having a Hooters-sponsored boat race this weekend, and I did hear on the radio that it is going on, that right now things are being pushed offshore just enough by our easterly offshore winds that they don't have to worry about hopefully too much of a respiratory distress or issues. So Clearwater's going ahead this weekend with a festival.
It's so distressing that it's on such a scale. I mean, I've been living here for 12 years now and just bought a house in Indian Beach where the smell is pretty awful. And it's affected restaurants. I mean, I'm sure you've covered all this. St. Armand Circles, it was empty during August. What are we doing? What are we doing as a community to address this?
Well,
I mean, I know it's a natural phenomenon that has been greatly exaggerated by a very simple thing. Phosphates being poured into the water. Why aren't we stopping that?
Well, one of the things we've talked about on our show, and I think it's important to talk about again, is that all of these businesses need our help in order to get through this.
Yes.
So even on the most basic level, just
go
ordering
out.
Takeout, hiring them to cater events, go and just spend money.
But I'm talking about the bigger thing. I'm trying to sell, I put my condo on the market because I bought a new house, and I've been told red tide has directly affected the number of people that are coming to look apartments downtown.
Because who wants to come on a day when it smells and actually
move
here?
What are we going to do? Sit around and do nothing as a community? We're just going to go, throw our hands up and go, we can't do anything about it.
We've got a lot of people working on it. There are a lot of research projects going on.
Yeah.
Yes, a lot of committees. Moat Marine is
Moat's been given
really
millions
hard
but we
to work
know
on
it's
it.
The phosphates pouring out of Lake Okeechobee. We know that's what
we
it
vote.
Is.
That's
there's
do.
A good
why
answer.
Doesn't every, why do you have to be in a political party to address this? Why isn't this our total
Well, the
problem?
Researchers would tell you they cannot pinpoint any due cause. You know,
I mean, can help them with this.
Well,
you put phosphates in.
Call Moat. That's going to be my answer to that one. All right, I'm taking the hard
we'll vote for you, Mike.
Hard turn on this one. It is a little surprising that in an age of smartphones and laptops, that vintage typewriters are making a comeback. So in the early 2000s, a New York City typewriter salesman said he sold about 10 manual typewriters in a month. No idea how he stayed in business.
Wow.
In recent years, that has skyrocketed to about 60 a month. And last holiday season, more than 100 a month. It is millennials that are the ones buying them and using them. The salesman says people love it because it takes us back to a slower paced time. And a surprising patron of the store in New York Tom Hanks. Oh. Now, it makes me feel really old that something I had to use in high school is now a relic for millennials. Yeah. But that aside, do you remember when people got into old sewing machines something to have?
Yeah.
Okay, there were better ones on the market. It was just an antique-y thing.
Mm-hmm. I read that there's an interesting thing about writing with a typewriter, especially if you're a creative writer. When you write with a computer, you're constantly going back and editing. I didn't like that sentence. So you keep stopping the flow of stream of consciousness. But on a typewriter, you don't really go back. You just keep going. You keep going, and then you edit it after you pull the page out.
And pencil edit and retype.
Yeah, so I think it might be, maybe it's that approach.
This doesn't seem so long ago to me. I remember when they came into our newsrooms in Connecticut, took all our typewriters away and put in computers. And I said, I'll never be able to use that. But now I'm not going to go back to a typewriter.
The thing is, I've never left the yellow pad and a fountain pen. That's the truth. And I think that's where we're eventually going. I'm at one of our new young staff members in the literary department. I was looking at her notebook. The penmanship was unbelievable.
Oh.
She's a millennial. She's like 21.
As in
about
bad
to go to grad
or
school.
Good?
As in brilliant.
Oh, great. Really?
I said to her, were you taught by nuns? Because I was taught by, that was the major thing, penmanship. Uh-huh. They didn't worry about curiosity, asking questions, or history, but penmanship was everything. No, she said it was my parents. They knew I wanted to be, she was one of six kids. They knew she wanted to be a writer or something unusual. Mm-hmm. And didn't worry about any of the other kids. But they wanted her to learn penmanship for an attention to detail. So I said, you write like no one else in your generation.
That's nice. Oh, yes.
Which is really, really interesting to see. And I'm not surprised to hear, this is new information, that millennials would be interested in typewriters, and interested for the slowing down idea. They want a sense of control of the environment because it feels like it's out of control.
Right. Yes, it does.
The technology is taking over.
Yeah, that's true. If your computer breaks,
everything's gone. The average person
can't go in and fix it.
They are. And I'm going, so wait a minute. I said, you're not writing all your stuff on computer? You're 21 years old. She said, no, I write everything in a notebook.
Good for her. Well, see, there is still hope for our future here. All right. Well, we mentioned that Tom Hanks likes typewriters. Speaking of Tom Hanks, we're actually getting our first look at what he will look like when he joins the neighborhood. Mr. Rogers' neighborhood, that is. Sony Pictures released a set of photos of Hanks donned in Rogers' trademark cardigan and sneakers. The story is based on a real-life friendship between Fred Rogers and a journalist named Tom Junod, who was a jaded magazine writer profiling the children's TV star. He writes how their relationship changed his life along the way. That film is currently set to release in October 2019. It's a decent replication.
Absolutely. So much like him there.
Yeah, and we all love him. There's a love for Tom Hanks that was for Mr. Rogers.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And even though he's a great actor, it's still, he's bringing that into the
role. It's useful not to have to get past anything to accept him in the role.
It's not like Johnny Depp.
And that list these days is very, very short.
There'll be no hearing to see if Tom Hanks is okay.
One can hope. Yeah. All right, we're going to check in with our mid-morning forecast before we get any more trouble. And when we come back, we're going to talk to Michael about the classic show Music Man at Oslo Rep.
We have a frontal boundary located back to the west. That frontal boundary kind of in the process of starting to decay. It will eventually give way to this big ridge of high pressure in the Atlantic and allow it to expand over the area. As that happens, we'll continue with an easterly wind flow across the region, and that easterly wind will keep the same sort of timing of storms as we've seen over the last several days, late afternoon and evening, and the same motion of those storms, generally coming up from the southeast, moving off to the northwest, and a few of them building back toward Gulf waters. That'll be true today, although tomorrow, as that high pressure ridge expands, we may have slightly fewer storms around. So, mostly sunny skies with late thunderstorms, slightly drier air over the weekend, and calmer weather as far as the tropics goes for the state of Florida. Today's forecast looks like this. Daytime high comes in near 90. We'll have about a 20% chance of a late afternoon storm inland, and then better rain chances in the evening.
It is the most wonderful time of the year here on the Suncoast, the opening of all of our theater's new seasons. Well, it is the 60th anniversary season for the Oslo Rep, and producing artistic director Michael Donald Edwards is our guest host today, and he's here to tell us more about how the season will start. All right, so you are starting the season with a classic.
With an absolute classic.
Literally with a bang.
With a bang.
What made you want to stage the classic musical?
Well, you know, Jeff Calhoun, the director, directed Bonnie and Clyde for us, and he did Pulse with Noah Race. He created that show with Pulse. We were at Joe Allen about 3 years ago, and he's mostly done only new work since then. He's actually going to London to do 9 to 5. He's the rival of Dolly Parton's
yes.
9 to 5. He just did a new song with her called Me Too, which is going into the London show after he does Eight Coast there. And I was in Joe Allen's with him 3 years ago. I said, Jeff, what will you, because he's often presenting new musicals to me that may not work, whatever. And he said, what is the marquee musical they want to do? Is there any big name you want to do? And he said, there's only one really that I've been in love with since I was a kid that got me into the business. I wanted to be Harold Hill, and that is The Music Man. Mm. Now, unbelievably, I didn't know The Music Man.
Really?
Oh,
and
really?
He sent me to read it, see the movie, which I did not love, and do some research into the piece itself. We had a lot of great conversation. He said, I want Noah Racey to do Harold Hill, which seemed perfect to me.
And that's who we're looking at. We're looking at pictures from the photo
shoot. That's who you're looking at right now. We just did a photo shoot of them here. They're an incredible combo, these two. And they represent Broadway song and dance. Both Jeff and Noah represent Broadway song and dance at its height. I mean, Jeff was Tommy Tune's protege, mm-hmm. Was on Broadway at the age of 17. After being a football player, became one of the best tap dancers in America.
Oh.
Jeff did. Then Noah became one of the best tap dancers in America. Was on Broadway in several things.
And Suncoast audiences,
there's a kind of Tommy Tune
will
legacy.
Noah. Suncoast audiences remember Noah from when he did the show at Oslo Red
Pulse. Pulse, yes.
Which was an amazing show. He's an amazing dancer, an amazing tap dancer.
Yeah.
With the combination of Jeff Calhoun directing and choreographing, and Noah is the lead. How is, you know? I know you don't just do a show just to do a show again.
No,
is
no,
there
no.
Gonna be
there's
a, new
a
take
whole
on it?
There's a whole different take with these guys Jeff has brought in this brilliant young choreographer, Paul McGill, that you can see on Google as a dancer and a choreographer, whom he thinks is like him when he was starting on Broadway. So the three of them together are like these three super talented dancer types who also sing and act, who are going to bring a level of contemporary movement and dance to the show that you've never really seen. Now, the show itself is a fascinating thing, because the character of Harold Hill...
Yeah, for people that don't know Music Man.
Well, he's a con man. I mean, he is a cheat and a liar, and he's made a business of fooling people. And he runs into this woman in this town who is a little bit of an outsider. She's a bit of a kook. She inherited a library. She's solo. She's looking after her disabled brother, and she's very suspicious of any man. And the two of them make the most unlikely combination. And watching Harold Hill, the ultimate cynic con man, get completely smitten by this woman, who exposes everything, every bit of his chicanery, she exposes it all, and says to him finally at the end, you know what? I saw the effect you had on my brother. I see something in you. Yeah. And that completely wrecks him.
You know what I think Suncoast audiences are going to love? It is some of the most classic Broadway
beautiful.
Music.
The music
there
is awesome.
You're going to know half the
76
songs.
76 trombones.
Yes.
Until there
Trouble
was
in
you.
River City.
Yes.
Well,
I mean,
and you know, the opening number, which was breathtaking to me, is like out of Hamilton. Because they realized that Lin-Manuel Miranda used that opening number from Music Man, the rhythm, because
it's got the pattern,
railroad rap thing. It's like that's the first rap song on Broadway. So it's got a direct connection to now. I feel like the story is, you know, he did 46 drafts of that piece.
Wow.
I mean, he honed it like a jewel, and it is a jewel.
And it's a great way to start what I know is going to be a great season.
It's going to be.
With a new take on a classic musical.
And it is totally a feel-good piece. I think people need it. We're going to need it. The midterms will have been done. Half the country will be devastated. And the other half will be relieved.
And we can
but when you come to the Oslo Rep, you'll all feel good.
That's a great way to look at it.
Tonight is a big night because single tickets go on sale online. Tonight at midnight, you can go to oslorep.org. Brand new website. Very user-friendly, by the way. And you can get your tickets for Music Man. It opens November 13th and runs through December 31st.
Yeah,
that's at oslorep.org. Coming up next, we're going to solve a mystery with the Arts Alliance.
ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you. Watch ABC 7 wherever you are, on our live stream, on mysuncoast.com, on the ABC 7 My Suncoast app, powered by the iAssociates, providing sight for life, featuring traffic maps and live radar, dining with recipes, and My Suncoast restaurant guide. Visit mysuncoast.com. Click on the apps tab to download the ABC 7 My Suncoast app for Apple and Android.
The final 2018 Accord clearance is now. During our model year-end clearance sale, drive new Accords for just $249 a month. Get an Accord, the North American car of the year, for less than the competition. With more standard features than Camry, Honda Sensing, multi-angle camera, turbocharged engine, and more. New Accords, just $249 a month. Your last chance for new Accords, all on clearance this week at your local Honda dealer.
Did you know you could get life insurance for less than 32 cents a day? With Guaranteed Acceptance Whole Life Insurance through TruStage, you can get up to $25,000 in protection with a single phone call. TruStage can help free your family from immediate financial stress when you're gone.
Utility bills, mortgages, car payments, those are a lot of things that can add up pretty fast.
And even if you're on a fixed income, prices fit your budget, starting at less than 32 cents a day. Plus, your price will never increase, and your benefit will never decrease. And with no medical tests or health questions, you cannot be turned down for any reason. Call 1-800-842-7189. Now, for a free, no-obligation quote, TruStage offers plans to fit your budget. Help protect your family from immediate financial burdens after you're gone with Guaranteed Acceptance Whole Life Insurance through TruStage. Call 1-800-842-7189 now.
I used to dread getting up and going to work.
I was done with the corporate grind.
I was tired of being a starving artist.
And I started looking around for a business that I believed in, and I kind of wanted to do something a little more green.
My SCORE mentor helped me take the first step.
He helped me create a business plan and helped me implement it.
They've really taught me how to think big.
SCORE helped me to make the unimaginable possible.
All for free. I'm here because of SCORE.
I'm here because of SCORE.
Get your free business mentor at score.org.
Are you good at solving a mystery? Could you have given Sherlock Holmes a run for his money? Here's an opportunity to test your problem-solving skills. The Arts and Cultural Alliance of Sarasota County is sponsoring a public art scavenger hunt. And to tell us how we can join the fun, we welcome Executive Director of the Alliance, Jim Shirley.
Thank you, Lynn. It's good to be here.
Ah, this sounds good, Jim.
Yeah, it is going to be good. Well, you know, the city of Sarasota and our community has a tremendous public art collection that a lot of people don't even know we have. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that we wanted to do is to be able to help people go out and engage in this collection in a fun way. And one of the things that we wanted to do is make sure that everybody could engage. So we put it in a very concentrated area. You'll be able to access the clues that you will follow through steps that will take you in less than 1 mile in downtown, easy to walk, easy to wheelchair, and get around and take a look at some of the public art that you pass every day but rarely see.
Jim, what is public art?
It's a very good question. Public art is typically art that is in the outside, in the open, that is available to all people. Very often it's sculpture, but sometimes it could be, you know, sides of buildings being painted, that sort of thing. But the big thing is it's not inside of an institution. It's out to where everybody can access it. And we think that's one of the most important things that we want people to realize is that we have the city of Sarasota, which is curated through a public art committee, has acquired a very large collection of public art over the years, and it sits all around us, but sometimes we don't see it. So we thought it would be
Surrender
fun to have
is one of the public art.
Surrender is one of those controversial pieces of public art.
How do we get our clues? It's not all at the same time. We can sort of do it at our own time.
You can do it at your own pace. You will be able to access the sheet, the clues, through the Arts Alliance website, sarasotaarts.org. It was also, I think they can access it from an article that was in the paper yesterday. And you go onto the site, you get the clues, then you walk and take the tour at your own pace. There's no hurry. Once you've taken the scavenger hunt, you fill in your answers, and then you send it in electronically to the Arts Alliance. And if you get them all right, we're going to send you back a prize.
Wow, I like that.
In the mail, we're going to send you back a prize.
Oh, that will be fun to wait for.
You get a piece of mail and you get a prize
at the
same time.
That's wonderful. Yeah. Now, you've got a big event coming up,
we
right,
do.
This weekend.
Well, that's not this weekend. It's on October 22nd.
October 22nd.
It's going to be at the Van Wezel Performing Arts Hall. It's our annual Celebration of the Arts.
Yes.
Where it's kind of a way to let a lot of our arts organizations show previews of their season. We also recognize people in the community who really make the arts happen, the artistic directors of the year, philanthropists, volunteers, and it's a really a good way to get to know the arts. It's free, it's open to the public, and we want everybody to attend.
Oh, what entertainment.
7 o'clock on Monday, October 22nd
at
the Van Wezel. Yes.
That sounds great, Jim. Thank you so much. And remember that Public Art Scavenger Hunt is now on, and to get those clues, you need to follow up. Go to Arts and Cultural Alliance website at thesarasotaarts.org. Next, shopping dozens of local vendors all in one Bradenton store.
This is an important message for anyone with Medicare. You may be eligible for an all-in-one Medicare plan that combines hospital, medical, and prescription drug coverage together with extra benefits that may include dental, vision, hearing aids, and much more. Some of these plans have a $0 monthly premium regardless of your income. That's right. For one low plan premium, or in some cases a $0 premium, you may be able to get coverage for your hospital visits, doctor appointments, prescription drugs, routine dental care, eyeglasses and contact lenses, hearing aids, and possibly more. Today may be the first time you've heard about this type of Medicare plan. The advisors at the Medicare.com helpline are licensed insurance agents who will explain more when you call. Call now to see if you qualify. Call the number on your screen now. Call now to see if you qualify for these benefits. You worked hard for your Medicare. Now is the time for your Medicare to work hard for you. Not affiliated with or acting on behalf of any government agency or program.
What do you get when you cross your tired, aching back with this fragile egg? The Egg Sitter Cushion, an amazing new flex cushion that supports your backside and spine so well you can sit on an egg without breaking it. Incredible!
You want me to sit on this egg? Okay. Can't believe I'm doing this. I don't even feel it. Didn't even break? Oh, I was wondering about that. Now that's a good cushion.
The honeycomb design is constructed of ElastiCore that absorbs pressure points by collapsing in on itself. That's why even this egg won't break under direct pressure. Now long days at the office will be more comfortable, dinner more enjoyable, and painful car rides a thing of the past. Get your Egg Sitter Support Cushion for just $39.99. It comes with a free non-slip washable cover and our 10-year comfort guarantee. But wait, call right now and you can get a second cushion. Just pay separate fee. Call now.
Call 1-800-232-1564. That's 1-800-232-1564. Call now or go to eggsitter.com. Order now.
The Players Center presents the Wild Broadway season opener, Annie, Get Your Gun. There's no business like show business. This slice of magical American musical theater will thrill you with the classic tunes of Irving Berlin. Call the Players Center at 365-2494 or visit us at theplayers.org. Annie, Get Your Gun, September 18th through October 7th. Let's go on with the show.
Dear parents, it's time for a pop quiz. What's the best kind of play for kids? Play that makes us think, or helps us pretend, or teaches us rules, or to be creative. Actually, every kind of play is important because different kinds of play give us different kinds of skills. Help us mix up the ways we play. Okay, class dismissed. Now go play.
Welcome back to Suncoast View. We're going to check in with Bob from Gold Rush Barbecue again. And Bob, you're a proud member, I know, of the Sarasota Originals Restaurant Group and also participating in an important event next week. Tell us about it.
Absolutely. Well, it's the start of Restaurant Week, where a lot of the restaurants in the area are offering specials for October 1st to the 9th through Sarasota Manatee Originals. And so you want to check out their website and find out. And last night they celebrated 15-year anniversary.
That's wonderful.
They gave us out these great towels, and we all had a good time at the Moat Marine Aquarium.
So. All right, eat like a local, one of my favorite things to remember. Yeah. So October 1 through 9, great deals. Go check out the local restaurants. Thanks,
Bob.
Joey?
We are all about shopping local here on the Suncoast, and it becomes even more fun when one store means dozens of different vendors, and no two items are alike. Well, now you can shop till you drop in Bradenton at 941 Artisan Lofts. And owners Angela Heck and Amy Nowak are here to tell us more about it. Welcome. How did 941 Artisan's Loft come about?
Well, Amy and I were friends, and she's the crafty one.
She was teaching me how to do crafts, and we decided to rent space in a local facility. And we decided to, we wanted to branch out on our own, and we're looking for space. We wanted to be closer to home and decided to open 941 Artisan Lofts so that we could showcase local artisans, local crafters. They have a lot of talent, and it's a way for them to have a small business within a larger business and not have to take so much of a risk.
Which is huge, I know, because having your own storefront and all of the things that go with that can be very difficult and daunting. All right, if we go, when we go to 941 Artisan Lofts, tell us what we can find.
Go ahead.
Well, we have 17 different vendors. Each has kind of their own unique style. We have farmhouse, country, boho, we have pottery, we have jewelry. I would say probably 75% to 85% of our items are handmade by the different vendors, or embellished, upcycled, refurbished.
Oh, so you're not going to find something like this anywhere else?
No, we have something for everyone.
Which is perfect for gifting.
Yes. Yes.
We all want creative items.
And you know that you're supporting a local vendor, which is great.
We
all
love.
Right, so you brought us, you said you have 17 vendors. You brought us just a sample of a few.
Right.
So let's start over here. This is Fresh Take, and I think we know the vendors here, the artist behind here. This is actually yours.
Fresh Take.
Oh, yeah. I love
so
the wine.
So tell us a little bit about what you brought and what Fresh Take has as a whole.
Okay. Well, Fresh Take, we do a lot with paint. We are a retailer of Dixie Belle chalk paint, so we do use that, but we also use regular latex paint and craft paint as well. We do a lot of signs, so like for instance this sign up in the front here is a sign that we made for a porch, and it's reversible, so one side is fall, the back side is actually Christmas.
Great idea.
I would say I don't know what's in front of it,
cool.
But this is our next class project that we're having. They're wine bottle witchy toppers.
Oh, that is so cool.
So when you take this to a party, you are giving them a holiday theme.
Yeah, so if you're going to a Halloween party, don't have to just take a bottle of wine.
Yes.
You can take a witchy bottle of wine.
Cool, and there we go. And it's got a little feet. So this is one of the things you're making at one of your classes coming up. And we're going to talk a little more about your classes and workshops. But I love the, you know, it's a great way to celebrate the holiday, especially when it doesn't always feel like fall weather here.
Right.
But we can go, we can certainly shop fall. All right, let's talk about the next one you brought. Tell me about Illuminations.
This is Illuminations. This is our vendor, Susan Myback. And she, this is her fall illumination. She does, these are all handmade. And you can get them to where they have a, the lights change.
Go. Oh, fun.
Yes. This makes an excellent gift. And she does a lot of seasonal decor. She's got the fall, Thanksgiving, Halloween.
Oh,
she has the holidays. And then she does a lot of coastal decor.
I love that coastal. Love that.
Yes, and a lot of people use these and as nightlights.
I was gonna say, it's a nice accent light or nightlight in the house that doesn't, you know, it's beyond just that typical plug it in the wall.
Right.
How great, and beautiful bow work, I have to say.
She is an excellent bow maker.
That's phenomenal. All right, let's talk about Soul Experience here, and maybe Linda can hold up one of those so we can see it.
Dream catcher.
Yes.
Oh.
Brenna is our vendor. She has Soul Experience, and she's our boho chic vendor. She has, this one is a breast cancer awareness.
Oh, how cute.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, nice. That's beautiful. And obviously very timely with Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
Yes. These are very trending. They trend, you know, a lot of young people love these. And she just did a class on these.
Oh, wow.
And she had just as many children in the class as she did adults. So this trends to be...
It does trend very young right now.
Yes.
You've got presents to give teens and college kids. They're very into dreamcatchers.
Beautiful.
Much so.
And then moving on to the Freckled Beachcomber.
I love these.
I like the name.
Repurposed, are those Scrabble pieces, right?
Yes. Donna comes to us from New Jersey, so she loves the beach, the water. A lot of her items have a coastal influence. She takes the Scrabble pieces, she customizes or personalizes it for whoever she's making it for.
So cute.
If you go on vacation somewhere and it's kind of like a special, you know, vacation, honeymoon, whatever, she'll take orders and she'll make those up. And it's just a nice way to, you know, have a little memorabilia from it.
And I see the board, the Scrabble board actually hangs.
That's really cool. Yeah, she makes larger sized ones, smaller ones that are tabletop. She embellishes them with, you know, different pieces that she's found.
Great thing with the shells that the kids find too. We always talk about what it is, and those part of their vacation. You could give her
whatever you have to collect and put it on for
you
a nice
mentioned
gift.
That there are classes and workshops. So mm-hmm. in addition to purchasing from the vendors, we can also learn some of the arts that they do.
Yes, matter of fact, this and the welcome sign at the bottom there, they were classes that we did. Susan has also done classes. She did also. Freckled Beachcomber hasn't yet.
How wonderful. Well, you can find the full schedule of all of these classes. You can also visit 941 Artisan Lofts. They are on 53rd Avenue East in Bradenton. And there is a special pop-up show. It's planned for October 7th from 10 to 3. There's going to be 30 artists, crafts, vendors, music, food trucks, all of it. For more information, go to 941artisanlofts.com. All right, coming up next, this weekend is podcast day on Sunday. We're going to tell you some of the great podcasts you need to start listening to catch up.
Growing up, my mom was afraid of the water, something she did not want me to feel.
So I enrolled Missy in swim lessons.
It changed my life.
Missy Franklin.
And now you can do the same for someone that you love.
There's nothing more precious than your child's well-being.
So act now before it's too late.
Make us
swim! I'm glad I did.
Thanks, Mom. Visit USASwimmingFoundation.org to find, get, or give a swim lesson.
Watch Good Morning Suncoast on ABC 7, weekdays starting at 5. This is an ABC 7 news update.
Good morning, I'm Ray Collins. Here are the headlines, the latest on Supreme Court showdown on Capitol Hill. How will a Senate committee vote on Judge Brett Kavanaugh's nomination to the U.S. Supreme Court? And we'll tell you which NFL quarterback is donating a canine officer to the Bradenton Police Department. It's all part of the athlete's charitable foundation. As far as the forecast, here's meteorologist John Scalzi.
So we'll watch today for a big ridge of high pressure to continue providing us with an easterly wind. As we get that easterly wind, we'll see our showers and thunderstorms building inland and drift to the coast. Winds will be generally out of the east right straight through the weekend, in fact, and that will lead to several things. One, a 20 to 30% chance of showers as our showers come up from the southeast, move to the southwest, and collide with our sea breeze that forms. And two, some warm temperatures topping out each and every day near the 90-degree mark.
Call to see if you qualify to enroll in a Medicare Advantage plan right now. At Humana, we believe great things are ahead of you when you start with healthy. And part of staying healthy means choosing the right Medicare plan. Humana can help. With Original Medicare, you're covered for hospital stays and doctor office visits when you're sick, but keep in mind, you'll have to pay a deductible for each. A Medicare supplement plan can cover your deductibles and coinsurance, but you may pay higher premiums than you do with other plans. And prescription drug coverage isn't included. But with an all-in-one Humana Medicare Advantage plan, you could get all that coverage plus Part D prescription drug benefits, all for an affordable monthly plan premium, and in some areas, no plan premium. It's all described in this free book. Call for yours and discover how an all-in-one Medicare Advantage plan from Humana could save you money. There is no obligation and the book is free. Call or go online right now.
My name is Blake. I received the heart transplant when I was 2 weeks old. I play defense for the Red Hot Tornadoes. Sometimes my heart starts pounding like faster and faster as I go. I know I have someone else's heart inside me. It makes me feel happy because someone was generous enough to give me a second chance to live.
This gift of life was made possible by an organ donor. Imagine what you could make possible. Sign up as an organ, eye, and tissue donor. Go to organdonor.gov.
Download the all-new ABC 7 First Alert weather app now.
Media experts are calling 2018 the year of the podcast boom. Podcast listening has seen a 14% increase this year. Now, one-third of Americans listen to their favorite podcasts every month, and there are so many to choose from. Apple actually confirmed this summer there's now over 550,000 active podcasts available. So where do we even start? So fortunately, Joey has been researching this, and I know you've been into podcasts for a while. You tell me all the time with my long drive I should be using more podcasts, but I'll admit, I don't know where to start.
Yes.
And so I need some narrowing down.
There is a ton. You know how you ask someone like, oh, what series should I binge next on Netflix or whatever, and they give you a laundry list? Same thing has happened with podcasts. I fell into them when I was commuting to St. Pete because I didn't want to keep listening to the same songs over and over. And it just, if you have a 45-minute drive, let's say, you can find a podcast that can pretty much take care of your highway time.
Okay.
This is so exciting.
Yes, and so they're free, which is the other thing a lot of people don't realize. It's free to subscribe to them, and there's typically an app on your phone. If you have an iPhone, there is a podcast app. So it couldn't be easier. It doesn't cost you anything. I've kind of broken them up into categories. I like to listen to them when I drive, also when I cook, because I love watching TV shows and everything, but you have to be looking at a screen. So you can't do that when you drive. And when you cook, you really can't be watching TV.
Right.
It's why audiobooks have become so popular again.
Yes.
I think people are really going back to listening to stories. So, True crime and documentary style is very, very popular. So a lot of people probably have heard of Serial, which was one of the podcasts a couple years ago that got everything much bigger. They will take a story and follow it for an entire season and really delve into it. The first season was all about a young man named Adnan Syed who was found guilty of murdering his girlfriend in high school. Well, what they did, producers of Serial, they went back in and they found that maybe his trial wasn't fair. And they really delve into the story, and they ended up bringing his case back up in court because of the research that they did. Everybody loved the first season. Second season, not as popular. They followed the army deserter, Bo Bergdahl. He was captured by the Taliban, and then his kind of controversial release 5 years later. But still, you can delve into a long story. So, and it's something you can pause if you're done with your drive or you get interrupted. There's a great feature that your podcast player will let you go back 15 seconds. So typically when I park my car, if I'm in the middle of a podcast, I hit 15 seconds back just so I can refresh where I was.
Good.
Same
yes.
as when you're reading a book before you go to bed. So from true crime, there's also a whole series of inspirational and educational podcasts. You hear me talk, I won't go on too much about my love of Oprah, but Super Soul Conversations are wonderful. She sits down with spiritual, religious leaders and just talks about ways to live your life, no matter where you are in the religious or spiritual spectrum.
Right.
It's something for you. I listen to them in the shower because it just puts me in a good mood in the morning.
We want you to continue to do that.
You've heard of TED Talks. Well, there's also the TED Radio Hour. So it'll take one topic and really give you a few, you get little snippets of TED Talks that are about that subject. So if you don't want to delve into one full TED Talk, you can listen to these. Steph, I thought of this one for you. It's called Revisionist History. I just started it.
Okay.
Malcolm Gladwell, he wrote The Tipping Point and Blink. Great author.
Right.
Yep.
His first podcast is called The Importance of the Semicolon, which sounds like it's all about grammar, but it's actually, he goes in and kind of looks at things in history that maybe weren't researched 100%. He talks about how a semicolon has changed the interpretation of the Constitution.
Oh.
So it gets very, very interesting.
Cool.
And he's a great author, so you can listen to his stuff. Linda, when we get into the entertainment aspect, there is one, there's one called You Must Remember This that covers Charles Manson's history. It's like a 12-episode series.
Steph, I know more about Charles Manson than his mother did.
And it's some stuff that you didn't know about him before. Steph, don't be offended, but the funny one that I picked for you is actually called, this is what it's called, My Dad Wrote a Porno. And it is about a British guy who finds out that his retired father, and this is real, has actually been writing soft erotic fiction along the lines of 50 Shades of Grey. So he and his friends get together and read the chapter out loud and comment. It is one of the funniest. I've had to actually stop listening when I'm on the highway because it makes me laugh so hard.
Oh, my. I don't know why he thought of you.
Yeah, we're just going to let that go.
There's a podcast for every sense of humor. I'll say that.
I want your list. This sounds so good.
Yes. All right. Well, thank you, Joey. And it's good, a good way to just educate yourself in something a little different, too.
Yeah, it's so just a new way to take an info.
All right, well, we're going to look into it. Thank you. We'll be right back.